Good morning to everyone. I hope you understood the last class and you are following the assignment properly, learning the everyday lesson thoroughly. And today we are going to, and in the last class we saw about the classification of molecule and the relative molecular mass. Today we will learn, even though there are some similarities between atoms and molecule, although this atom is an entity present in the molecule, but there are some differences. So today we will learn the difference between atoms and molecule. What are the difference between atoms and molecule? Atom is the smallest particle of an element. Atom is the smallest particle of an element, and this molecule is the smallest particle of an element or compound. Atom is the smallest particle of an element and molecule is the smallest particle of an element or compound. Molecule is the smallest particle of an element or compound. Element or compound. And this atom exists in free state. And this atom does not exist in free state except noble gases. Atoms does not exist in free state except noble gases. So except the noble gases, this atoms does not exist in free state. And here this molecule exists in free state. Molecules exist in free state. And here the atoms are highly reactive. Except noble gases. Atoms are highly reactive except noble gases. Why these noble gases are not reactive? Because of the stable configuration or completely filled configuration of the noble gases leads to the stability of the noble gases. So here these atoms are highly reactive except noble gases. So noble gases are not reactive. Except noble gases. Here molecules are less reactive. Molecules are less reactive. They are not much reactive as atoms. The atoms exist singly, but they are reactive, whereas this molecule, it will be present along with two or more atoms, so they are less reactive. And the atoms does not have a chemical bond. They won't have a chemical bond, whereas these molecules or the atoms in the molecules are held by chemical bond. Atoms in molecules are held by chemical bond. So these are the difference between atoms and molecules, and this can be asked in short answer. Okay, so atom is the smallest particle of an element, molecule is the smallest particle of an element or compound, atom does not exist in free state except noble gases, and here the molecule exists in free state, and atoms are highly reactive except noble gases, and molecules are less reactive, and here atom does not have a chemical bond, whereas these atoms and molecules are held by chemical bond. So these are the difference between atoms and molecule. Now we'll see the mole concept. See, we have to express the quantity. For example, when you go to a shop, we have to buy some rice. We cannot ask simply rice. We have to mention the quantity of rice, or it must be expressed in grams or kilograms. For example, 1 kg, 2 kg or 5 kg we have to express. Similarly, scientists, they express the number of atoms in terms, number of atoms and molecules in terms of mole. For example, if you want to get a pair of bangle, you'll have 2 items, whereas if you want to get a dozen of eggs, it'll have 12 eggs. Similarly, the mole denotes the number of particle. So we are going to learn about mole concept. This mole is nothing but the number of particle. According to the chemist, the mole denotes the number of particles. The mole denotes the number of particle present in a substance. So here this mol denotes the number of particle present in a substance. Or in the SI system, the number of mole is nothing but as many elementary entities. The mole is defined as the number of as many elementary entities. For example, atoms or molecules or ions present in 12 gram of the carbon 12 isotope is known as what? Mole. And now, for example, in 12 gram of the isotope, how many atoms of the carbon is present? So it can be determined experimentally, and it was given by a scientist, Italian scientist or physicist. He is a physicist. Italian scientist. Whose name is Amedeo Avogadro. Amedeo Avogadro. So this one word will be asked in any 10th or 11th or 12th standard. So this is very important. Italian scientist Amedeo Avogadro, he gave a value to represent the number of atoms present in the carbon 12 isotope or number of particle present in the carbon 12 isotope. That is represented by symbol Na. Na is nothing but the Avogadro number. So Na is equal to 6.023 into 10 power 23. So Avogadro number is nothing but Na is equal to 6.023 into 10 power 23. For example, 5 gram of oxygen molecule is present. How many particles are present? We want to express then. It will be equal to 5 moles of oxygen. Then 5 moles of oxygen we want to express. Then it will be equal to 5 into 6.023 into 10 power 23 particles or atoms or molecules of oxygen present in that substance. So this will give the mole concept. Now how this mole, number of moles can be calculated? So when you have these values, you can easily calculate the number of moles, or these data are given, then you can easily calculate the number of moles. For example, number of moles of molecules, number of moles of molecule is given, then you can calculate the moles. Then number of moles of atoms, number of moles of atoms, and the number of mole of gas, number of moles of gas, number of moles of gas is present. For example, the molar volume of gas at STP will be molar volume of gas at STP. So STP is nothing but standard temperature and pressure. So molar volume of gas at STP will be equal to 22.4 liter or 22,400 ml at standard temperature and pressure. What is the standard temperature and pressure? Standard temperature is 273.15 and pressure is 1 atmosphere. 273.15 and pressure is 1 atmosphere. So this is the standard temperature and pressure. So at that standard temperature and pressure, the molar volume of gas is 22.4 liter or 22,400 ml. So this is the what? And the number of moles of ion is present. So if these values are present, you can easily calculate the number of moles. Number of moles of ions is present. So these data will lead to the calculation of this number of moles. And when you want to express the number of moles of atoms, so number of moles of atom is nothing but Avogadro number of the particle present in the gram atomic mass, or number of molecule is present. For example, number of moles of atoms of oxygen is present. Then 6.023 into 10 power 23 particles of 16 gram, that is the gram atomic mass. The number of moles of molecule you want to express. For number of moles of oxygen, then it is 6.023 into 10 power 23, or gram molecular mass of that oxygen will be what? 32 grams. So this is how you have to calculate the number of moles. So the mole concept is nothing but it is the collection, or it is a collecting unit of number of particle present in a bulk of matter. Number of units or number of particle present in a bulk of matter, which is used to represent the molar volume or mass. Okay, it can be expressed using this Avogadro number, or we can express the number of particle present in a substance using the Avogadro number. So this is how you have to calculate the number of moles. So if these values are given, you can easily calculate the number of moles. What are the different modes of calculating? What are the different formulas of calculating the number of moles? So we'll see. So number of moles is equal to mass divided by atomic mass. Mass divided by atomic mass. Then number of moles is equal to mass divided by molecular mass. Molecular mass. Or number of moles is equal to number of atoms. Number of atoms divided by Avogadro number, that is Na. So Na is nothing but 6.023 into 10^23. This can be asked in one word. Then another formula, number of molecules or number of moles of molecules divided by Avogadro number. So this will give the number of moles. So number of moles you can express, if you have mass and atomic mass, you can calculate the number of moles, and if you have mass and molecular mass, you can calculate the number of moles. If you have number of atoms and you know the Avogadro number, you can calculate the number of moles, and if you have the number of molecules, you can calculate the number of moles using the Avogadro number. So these are the different modes of representing or calculating the number of moles. So next we'll see the percentage composition. How to calculate the percentage composition? Percentage composition is nothing but mass of the element present in 100 gram of the compound. Percentage composition. Now we'll calculate the percentage composition. So if you want to consider the atoms and molecules present in a substance, you have to calculate the percentage composition also. How much percentage of that particular element is present in that particular compound? You have to consider that also. So we have to calculate the percentage composition, or it is very important to know about the percentage composition also. So how to calculate the percentage composition? Percentage composition. So percentage composition is nothing but mass of the element present in 100 gram of the compound. Mass of the element present in 100 gram of the compound. In 100 gram of the compound. Mass of the element present in 100 gram of the compound. Now let us consider an example. For example, we'll consider this water. We have to calculate the percentage composition of the hydrogen and oxygen present in water. So what you have to do? We are having one formula, that is mass percentage is equal to mass of the element. Mass of the element in the compound. Mass of the element in the compound divided by mass of the element in the compound divided by molar mass of the compound. Mass of the element in the compound divided by molar mass into 100 will give the mass percentage of that element in water. For example, we'll calculate the molar mass of water. First of all, we have to calculate the molar mass. So here the formula is H2O. How to calculate the molar mass? So here 2 hydrogen is present. So 2, and what is the atomic mass of this hydrogen? It is 1. So 2 into 1 plus what? Oxygen. 1 oxygen is present, and we know that 1 oxygen, then it is what? 1 into 16. Its atomic mass is 16. So 2 in 2 plus 16, it will give 18 gram. So its molar mass is 18 gram. Gram molar mass is 18. So here we have to substitute. We have to find out the mass percentage of hydrogen. Then we have to find out what? Mass percentage of oxygen. So mass percentage of hydrogen is equal to, so what is the formula? Mass of the element in the compound. What is the mass of hydrogen in water? It is 2. So 2 divided by 18 into 100. It will be equal to 11.11%. And here we have to find out the mass percentage of oxygen also. So here what is the atomic mass of oxygen? It is 16. And what is the molar mass of that compound? It is 18. So 16 divided by 18 into 100, it will be equal to 88.89%. So when you add these two, you will get 100%. So here the 100% of water in the compound, how much mass percentage of hydrogen is present? 11.11%. And how much amount of this oxygen is present? It is 88.89%. So how to calculate mass percent? First you have to calculate molar mass of that compound by adding the atomic mass of that element, and then next you have to calculate the mass of the first element, that is hydrogen, and then you have to calculate the mass of second element, that is oxygen. For what it is useful? For what this mass percentage calculation is useful? It is very much useful in predicting the empirical formula as well as the molecular formula of the compound. So mass percentage is useful in predicting the empirical formula and as well as molecular formula of the compound. So this is very useful in determining the empirical formula and molecular formula. And we'll see another example also. So we'll see another example, that is methane. What is the formula for methane? CH4. So let us calculate the mass percentage of methane, CH4. So the formula for methane, first of all you have to know the formula. Formula for methane is CH4. So mass percentage is equal to mass of the element in the compound. Mass of the element in the compound divided by molar mass of the compound. Mass of the element in the compound divided by molar mass of that compound. Molar mass of CH4. Molar mass of CH4. What you have to do? First we have to do the calculate the molar mass of CH4. So molar mass of CH4 is equal to, so we know that carbon is present first. So what is the atomic number of carbon? It is what? Atomic mass of carbon, it is 12, and only one carbon is present, so 1 plus. And here what is the atomic mass of hydrogen? It is 1, and 4 hydrogen is present, so 4. So 12 plus 4, it will be equal to 16. So here the molar mass of methane is 16 gram. Now we'll calculate the mass percentage of first element, that is carbon. So mass percentage of C, it will be equal to, what is the mass of carbon here? It is 12. 12 divided by, what is the molar mass of this compound? That is 16 into 100%. So it will be equal to 75%. Okay, so out of 100%, 75% is carbon. And remaining what? 25% will be what? This hydrogen. We are going to find out that also. So mass of hydrogen, or mass percentage of hydrogen, is equal to, here we know that the atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. So here 4 hydrogen is present. So 4 divided by, what is the molar mass of this compound? This is 16. So 4 divided by 16 into 100, it will be equal to 25%. So 75 plus 25%, when you add, will get 100%. So out of 100% in this compound, 75% is carbon and 25% is what? This hydrogen. So this is useful in predicting the empirical as well as molecular formula of the compound. So we have done two examples, that is in water we have calculated the mass percent, and in what? Methane also we have calculated the mass percent of the element present. So it is very much useful in predicting the empirical and the molecular mass. So the book example I want you to do, the exercise problem, one sum is given, that you do it as an assignment. Okay, so today we have learnt about what? The difference between atoms and molecule, and the mole concept, the Avogadro number. Amedeo Avogadro, he is a scientist, Italian scientist. Its value is 6.023 into 10 power 23. Moles are nothing but, it denotes the number of particle present in a substance. And what are the data are given, that is used to calculate the moles, that is number of atom, number of molecular ion, or number of moles of gas, molar volume of gas. molar volume of a gas is nothing but 1 mole of any gas that occupies 22.4 liter or 22,400 ml of the solution is known as molar volume. Okay, so molar volume of a gas is also can be asked in one word. That is, molar volume of a gas is what? 22.4 liter or 22,400 ml. So you can expect these one word in this concept. And the different modes of expressing the number of moles, that is, number of moles will be equal to what? Mass divided by atomic mass, or it will be equal to mass divided by molecular mass, and then it will be equal to what? The number of atom divided by Avogadro number, and the number of molecules divided by Avogadro number. And then we saw percentage composition. It is nothing but the mass of the element present in 100 gram of the compound. And we have calculated the mass percentage for two compounds, CH4 and water. And this will be very useful for you. And this is useful in calculating the empirical as well as the molecular formula. So today's assignment, you do the book exercise problem in this percentage composition, and also you write the difference between atoms and molecules as an assignment and send it in the group. Okay, thank you for listening to me. Thank you.